bodybuilding, I don't really look at people's credentials. I look at what they look like.
Right there. You can't do that with muscle.
I don't really look at people's credentials. I look at what they look like.
And he wants his audience to do the same thing. Not look at the credentials that he does not have and look at what he looks like, which is partly an illusion. I've been telling people this for now 7 years, that you can't just follow someone who has a lot of muscle and do what they do and expect to get those same results. And that's because the biggest determining factor in getting muscle is not your workout routine. These YouTubers want you to believe that because they can sell that to you. That's something sellable, something they can make money from. It's not your diet either. It's a little bit of both, but it is mostly something else. People, this is gross ignorance. I'm starting to just believe there's no use. This is it, people. This is your last hope to avoid the invasion of the mind snatchers. In my last video, that was about Frank, and I said that that video would be a test to see if people would watch the video where I wanted to tell people the truth. People did not show up from Frank's channel. And so this will be my last video on Frank Tufano, the conspiracy truther turned muscle man in 1 month. I now see that I've wasted my time on the dumbest people in the world.
Is a testament to my advice, especially in the short span of time.
Just look at the sick conundrum that we have all found ourselves in.
Horrible, dangerous technique, and uses very little weight.
That's just weird. I used that word again without even thinking about it. Remember when I used that word in my live debate with Bert 1.5 years ago? Just weird is the word for these people. He's weird in just almost everything he does.
So this makes me a little bit suspicious that Frank could be taking steroids. I wouldn't expect any normal person to make any progress training this way. I'd expect somebody to hurt themselves. He's so weak he can't lift heavy weights. I think that saved him from a few injuries just because he's not even lifting with enough weight to hurt himself. But again, still, I would not expect any person, any normal person to make progress. And he only gained about 6 pounds. He did make a pretty substantial physique transformation, and that is pretty atypical of that sort of training.
I did not know that he only gained 6 pounds, but I did notice something about these two pictures. Vegan Gains mentions that it's not the weight that has transformed so much in these pictures. It is the physique, or in other words, what I notice is the way the pictures look. His physique looks as if it's bigger, but if you look back and forth between the pictures, you notice the muscles just seem to be bulging more, and that gives your mind the impression that they're much bigger. But really look back and forth between the biceps. And there are a number of things Frank can be doing here in lieu of gaining massive muscle in 1 month. These things include possibly taking something to make his muscles swell, and you can also get that effect after working out. He probably lifted weights just before this video. And in the before picture, you see that he's standing up really straight, which makes his pectorals stretch out and look less big. He has a tan, and you can see that it makes a difference. Along with the lighting, he's probably using lighting in a way that creates a lot of contrast, and he just might have made the before picture with bad lighting. And one of those things that people don't realize is with lighting, you can make yourself look pretty bad, much different. Notice he's kind of washed out. The brightness is up. But then once you get the picture into a program like Photoshop or Paint, which I use, you can even affect the pictures more. Then, of course, there's reducing your body fat for the day, and you never hear people talk about diuretics. In Frank's videos, you don't get the sense of him being a short person, but he has to be at that body weight, and being short makes your muscles look more compact. Short height means your arms are short too, and so your muscles are just going to look that much bigger in pictures and video, where your mind doesn't see the shortness. So if he was like a 6-foot-tall person, then that muscle would be really impressive. But he's not near 6 feet. He's near 5 feet. The changes you've been through. Okay, I got this picture in the paint.net program. This is a higher level version than the one that comes with computers. Do some photoshopping. I don't think I've ever done this before in a video, so this will be fun. And this is all on the fly here, spontaneous. So take away some of the tan. Saturation. Oh. See, a little difference there. Now see, we could brighten this. Yeah, let's do that. Now see, look, as I move this lever. See what a difference it makes. And that's not even the contrast. Here's the contrast. Making him look more like a woman than he is. Turn down the contrast and look what happens. Then look, we could make this picture look better. Yeah, see, look. If I keep doing this enough, I'll make it look like he didn't make any gains. Probably not, because there's still probably something he took to get that swole look. Let's see. And we can give him a tan, so to speak. Add some color. See, it works with the color that's already there and just enhances it. And enough said. You can see where the lighting of the pictures made a big difference. This looks just too washed out now. Normal color. Yeah, that's a close match. So I'm going through Vegan Gains video finally, and listen to this. This is referring to Frank donating blood.
And gay men are at a way higher risk of contracting HIV, so they do put restrictions on gay men for donating blood.
What I was thinking while watching this is, I would have never thought of this angle. So that got me thinking, how does Vegan Gains know this? I would have never thought of that. Then another thing
is they don't let you donate blood at all if you're gay under any circumstances. In some areas, they allow you to donate so long as you haven't had any sexual intercourse for a certain period of time. Since Frank has admitted to working as a gay prostitute, he literally admitted on camera that he has had sex with lots of dudes for money.
Pause. In this video, Vegan Gains never brings up something that I'm about to, or maybe he's just trying to avoid it. But here in my video, I'm just spilling the beans. That Frank is just a big con man. You can expect everything he does to be fake. Frank lives in New Jersey. I live in the same country as he does. And prostitution is illegal here. It's not something you go admitting to on the internet. So while most people out there won't catch that, such as Frank's viewers and the general YouTube audience, they'll be so shocked at what he said that they will believe it. See, that's one of the tricks that con men use. And they might also think he's crazy or stupid. But I'm going past all of that and saying he is lying. He's lying about just about everything. No one would admit to a crime on social media. And no one would lift weights like this. What the fuck is he doing with his head? The fact that I've been telling people this for 7 years. It seems like people don't want to know. Right, the truth isn't going to help you gain muscle. Right, maybe that's why people don't want to hear it. Think about it, people. These are young people. If any man could get these kind of muscles, they would be doing it. Look around the world. There's a ton of men out there that don't have big muscle. I'm one of them, and I have tried to gain muscle for 40 years. Wow. And that just occurred to me. I was like 10 or 11 when me and my brother got a weight set. Oh, he's real skinny too. He's skinnier than me. We tried. I continue to try. And man, the responses I get every time I say that is so irritating. I'm starting to just believe there's no use. You all think you're not making gains because you're just not doing the right thing. And you want to believe the right thing is, what is the right thing here? Frank said to gain muscle, you don't read a book, you lift weights. It just occurred to me, but to gain muscle, you don't read a book, you also don't watch a video. So what is this video for, if all you have to do is lift weights?
I'm just here to present information to you guys and give you guys my thoughts.
And you've got all of these gurus on YouTube, and almost none of them are going to actually help you gain muscle.
I think I spent months and months and months, almost a year, doing the same weight. I tried eating more food, and I wasn't making any progress. And these people would just say, oh, you're not eating enough, just keep at it, you'll break the plateau. But
Yeah. Those people in the bodybuilding forums. These people who just keep telling you the same ignorant stuff. And just eat more. They're always missing something. And I think they're missing this one thing because they don't want to accept that one thing. So I am giving up on this issue. This is your last chance to save yourself.
So I took a break. And I took about 2 years off. I lost pretty much all the muscle. I was down to like 135 pounds.
This I don't understand. How do you just lose all your muscle? Well, is he giving away the fact that he did use steroids to get that muscle? Because it's steroid muscle that goes away real easy. And 135? Wow, he must be real short. But man, I've weighed that much.
Early 2015.
Wait, I almost weigh that much now. So never mind. Yeah, he's got to be like 5'1".
I had an itch to get back into weightlifting because fitness got popular again.
So Frankie likes to do things that are trending?
You know, around 5-6 years ago is when fitness really started blowing up.
Oh, and speaking of blowing up, I'd just like you to take a look and analyze this. This is Frankie's blood test from a month ago, where his testosterone level was 33.2, and today it's 100. Now, what does that tell you? And now I'm going to tell you the missing ingredient. How do you get muscle gains? Well, you might already be on to the answer I'm going to give. But really, the answer is in what it is not, which I've just spent a long time covering. What you really needed was to see that all the stuff they tell you and sell you... Oh, that rhymes. It's all a scam. Well, not for everyone. Some people will gain muscle from those kinds of techniques. But the reason some people gain muscle and some people don't is really simple, and you can't make money off of it, so they don't bother telling you. But it's nice to have those people who can't make gains because they are your repeat customers. Those people cannot make gains because they just don't have the genetics. See, I'm the kind of person who wants to know the truth. So it's hard for me to accept that there are some people that don't want the truth. And with that being said, I will never say that again. No more critiquing bodybuilders. No more trying to help those people who want to follow them and believe that they can find a way. And I've said enough. I have many videos about Frankie that show that he is all of the above. Dumb, crazy, and a con man. Also, no more response videos. I've given up trying to change people. And so my channel is going to change instead. Giving up on people means I'll go back into my own world where I was when I was happy and making progress too. When it's time to change, you've got to rearrange. We are into what you're gonna be. Sha-na-na-na-na-na-na-na. Sha-na-na-na-na. Sha-na-na-na-na-na-na-na. Sha-na-na-na-na. When it's time to change, you've got to rearrange. And I've also given up on the pandemic. It was like a month or so ago, I gave up any hope this problem's going to be fixed here in the United States. And as we can see, I was right. But here I'm going to give my final word. Back in March, when Dr. Fauci was saying don't wear masks, people like Frank and other COVIDiot conservatives used that to try to make him look bad. Well, even back then, I knew that was wrong and that we should have been wearing masks in March. But these critiquers are being disingenuous, because didn't we all know the reason Fauci and everyone else was saying, actually just not saying, to wear a mask? No one was wearing a mask yet, and they were just putting off where they had to force people to wear masks or get them to wear masks. And the main reason why they didn't want everyone wearing masks is because the U.S. didn't have enough masks. And if people all went out buying up all of the masks, that would leave no mask for the most important people, the first responders at hospitals. They need them more than anyone. Okay, I'm done with that. So most of these people pulling these disingenuous arguments, they're just being political. It's going to do you no good to listen to them or take them seriously, playing politics. And that has gotten us nowhere. Lies don't help you. You only get somewhere by following the truth. And here is a clip that shows just how hopeless it is.
97,000 kids have tested positive. That was such a shock to me, because I had heard kids really don't get it. If they do, they're all going to be okay.
How could news reporters living in a pandemic for months, on the most watched cable news show, Fox News, have 95,000 kids contract and likely spread the virus without the news team at Fox News being aware? And how could you believe that kids wouldn't get this virus? You know, these people aren't the antidote to all the bad information out there. They're the opposite extreme of it.
What's really crazy is how easily the media is able to continually lie and gaslight. One sentence saying, cases are at an all-time high. It's a catastrophe. The next sentence saying, kids are going back to school.
Now, I gotta ask straight out, is Frank this dumb? Does he watch the news and can't even comprehend the politics going on?
Are people so mentally inept?
He played his audience by just stating a whole bunch of conspiracy theories and never showing why they would be true.
It's been so obvious.
Making claims, never explaining them, and never backing them up with logic.
Of course, the sheeple line up.
It's because he is bullshitting, and how stupid does he think his audience is? Well, turns out, Frank is not very popular. Yes, he's got 100,000 subscribers now, but when you look at his views, and you see his views are 7% of his subscribers, you wonder how he's getting those subscribers. And that 7% ratio is almost as bad as my ratio. But I have a good excuse. I've been making videos twice as long as Frank, and so that's a lot more people that have drifted away over the years. That's the YouTube turnover rate. People are just not watching him. They drift off easily because they see that he never says anything of substance that you can use, and he just makes up stuff to get attention.
They're targeting these meat processing plants with radiation, making the workers sick. This is how they're going to take meat away. Take meat away and make everyone a slave because their minds...
Okay, I'm done. I don't want to waste my life on Franky. Now, if people really wanted to hear my commentary on this kind of thing, then yeah, that would be worth doing. But it looks like YouTube has shown that they would rather watch Frankie's psychotic raving.
Everyone is sitting inside with half a refrigerator full of food. One world government, these evil, satanic, crazy psycho lunatics control over people's minds.
I think this is a testament to the absurdity of America, man.
So my next video... Well, my next two videos will be a big step in my evolution on YouTube. And it's not for my own ego. It's for you. I'm doing all this for you. You follow my path and take my advice, you'll be truly free, like I have been. I'm trying to pass that to you. Subscribe now and get on this journey that I am taking you. And as if you need any more to understand Franky is a fraud, he blocks anyone from commenting who is critical of him. He can't defend himself. He's got 100,000 subscribers and can't handle a vegan loser like me. So he hides from me. He blocks me. I win. I am done, son.
Is staying locked inside like a rat for 6 months normal? To most people it is.
I'll go for a walk outside now. my son's calling my name.
He's calling me. I gotta get up, gotta get out, gotta get away.
Show me the way to be happy now. I just can't stay in.